Hey everybody, welcome back to Spooky Pizza Gift Shop. It's been a while. I have been working on getting the next issue of my Linux zine done, the codex, or as some people have said, it's pronounced the codec because it rhymes with LaTeX. Anyway, just a quick video about what this is about. Took me forever to get this one done. We have the final salad days, which talks about my experience at computers when I went back to college in 2008 to get my English degree. I also have a whole section that was going to be in here about how to be good with computers. And really, it's how to be good with anything or be seen, how other people might see you as good. Talking more about Bash, because I love doing Bash scripts. I am doing Bash aliases for Git in this one, because that just makes life easier when you're doing a lot of Git commits. I also have a bash command for Git. Then I have a thing called the hierarchy of errors, and I realize I probably titled that wrong. It's the right ways versus the wrong ways, because my whole life I've been told there's a right way and a wrong way to do things. Turns out there are multiple right ways and multiple wrong ways, and I tried to put these in an order that makes sense, because then I can tell, are the improvements I'm doing actual improvements, or are they taking me in the wrong direction? And then I spend quite a bit of time discussing that. So you might disagree with me on some of these things, and that would be great. Also talk about some scanning software, because I'm still doing scanning of stuff so I can be as digital as possible. Interleaving is a very important thing because my automatic document feeder doesn't duplex. So you have to it's either very laborious to scan things one page at a time, or you can scan a bunch of things, flip them over, scan the backsides, but then you have to rearrange things so that they look right. So we talk about that. Chemistry in LaTeX. I talk about three different packages to do chemistry typesetting, which are actually pretty cool. It makes me excited about chemistry, and that's not something you often hear people say. But I talk about the MHChem package, the Chem formula package, and the ChemFig package, which lets you draw things like acetic acid, but it also lets you create ring structures. And this is organic chemistry was my favorite form of chemistry, so this kind of makes me pretty happy. So we can do 3D versions of glucose and other things. We can do reactions. So, and I show you how to do that here. Then I just talk about the things I learned about LaTeX while creating this one. And especially how to do drop caps, because over here, hang on, look, I did drop caps in that story, because it was kind of two sections. So I had a little bit of an intro. There's one section, there's another section, but there was no point in having a title, but I wanted to show that it's something different. So a drop cap seemed to be the way to go, and that was fun. So there's also a little afterword. I did have a mailing list set up on my website that MailChimp used to do a free thing called Tiny Letter. They got rid of it, and so now I don't have a mailing list. But if you want to get on my mailing list for my zines, I do give you my email address here, and you can just send me an email, and I will let you know. I don't get zines out very often, so it's not like you're going to be getting messages all the time. So I will include a link in the description of this video, where you can find more information about this zine or my other zines, because I have a whole website just for my zines. And then I'll include a link to the Etsy page where you can buy this. So thanks for watching. If you buy this, I hope you like it. I'm not happy with this color paper for the cover because it's kind of dark. I wanted to go with something like a bright orange, but it was like $21 for a ream, and I needed like 20 sheets. So I had this purple in the closet, so I can't afford $21 for 10 sheets or 20 sheets of orange paper. So purple it is, and it's kind of a nice shade of purple. So thanks for watching. See you next time.